Honestly, it's really cold. I can't believe it's 40 degrees right now, but it's so cold because we have a mostly clear sky, which is really good. I'm looking at some of the high clouds right now. If this is what the sky would look like at totality in exactly 7 hours to the minute, I think we're looking pretty good. Let's talk about that path of totality. It is night and day difference. For example, OKC is about 94%. Versus southeastern Oklahoma is 100%. If you're over in Atoka, Ada, McAllister, that is not good enough. You need to be to the right or to the east of that yellow line. You need to be down in Beavers Bend, Broken Bow, where I'm at here in Idabel. So what can you expect when it all happens? Basically, if you're in the path of totality, it's like the sun is setting, but it's not. It's overhead, the sky becomes dark. It'll be so dark out, you can actually see some planets and some constellations. Now, when it comes to this rare event, I was looking back at some of the information. The last 150 years, we've only had 15 total eclipses across the United States, and we've only had two across Oklahoma, one in 1878, and the last one, which was a total for Oklahoma, was 1918. That's been 106 years in the making. Let's talk about the timeline. I will get specific right now about Idabel. The partial starts at 12:30, so that's when the disk of the moon will start to cover up the sun. Totality starts at 1:45, and that's when the sky becomes pitch black. Understand that that will last for about 4 minutes and a couple extra seconds. That is a lot longer, twice as long as the solar eclipse that happened across the United States back in 2017. It will peak at 1:47, and then the partial will end at 3:07 down here in Idabel. The timing is about the same in OKC. The partial starts at 12:27, it peaks at 1:45 and ends at 3:07. I will say this though, please, if you're gonna be down in Idabel, be careful with the traffic, be patient with everybody as you're heading back. In OKC, when you look at the partial, you have to have eclipse glasses on or you will do damage to your eyes and vision. Versus in totality, you can actually take your glasses off. When it comes to the risk of severe weather, we have a risk. It does clip southern Oklahoma. The good news, it's for hail and it's for later tonight, not at 3 p.m., not at 5 p.m., should be a little bit later. So that's some really good news. And the tornado risk for tonight should stay down in Texas. Taylor will have the updated timeline for those storms, but reporting live in Idabel for the Great Solar Eclipse of 2024, I'm meteorologist Jonathan Conder.